When I was a teenager, I was in the Air Training Corps, and when I was about 15, I got the opportunity to learn to glide. So I went to 642 Volunteer Gliding Squadron at Royal Air Force Linton on Ouse near York and learned to glide. And the cool thing about the 642 VGS was that they taught you to glide in motor gliders. So I actually got to fly and go solo in a powered aircraft, which I thought was brilliant and still do. Sadly, 642 Volunteer Gliding Squadron seems to have disappeared now, along with Royal Air Force Linton on Ouse. The aircraft I learnt to glide on was the Slingsby Venture T2, which was a uprated version of the Scheibe Falk. And the Scheibe Falk is available as an add-on to X-Plane 12. Now, it's not quite the same as the Venture T2. It's got a less powerful motor and it's got a different instrument panel. But it does come with an Air Cadets livery, and I thought it would be fun to do a flight from RAF Linton on Ouse, which is still available in X-Plane despite them being closed, to the other two gliding clubs that I had the opportunity to glide from when I was a teenager. This is that flight. We fly southeast from Linton on Ouse, fly over York, turn over the Minster, and go roughly east to Pocklington, where we will land and take off. And then we'll cut north, fly to Pickering, and then turn west and land at Sutton Bank, which is one of the most fun places I've ever flown from. We start the flights on the threshold of 2-1, engine off, canopy open. Have a quick look at the aircraft before we take off. There are two undercarriage configurations for the model in X-Plane. This one with a single main wheel and the two outriggers is the one I remember from the Venture. So it's the one I've opted for. The paint scheme is exactly as I remember it. Well, let's hop in the cockpit, close the canopy, get the engine started, and get into the air. The runways for Linton and Ouse, I think, were built for Lancaster bombers originally, and it always made me smile when we would take off and barely get past the numbers before we were in the air when we were flying these tiny little gliders. as we fly over York, you can see the Minster on our left-hand side, which is our turning point as we make our way to Pocklington. There was something wonderfully and gently chilled about the flight experience in the Falk, as it just sort of effortlessly wafts through the air. Preparing for the landing at Pocklington, it is possible to land the Falk with the engine running, but I was always taught to turn the engine off before landing and glide in, so that's what I'm going to do. Now, in the Venture, we had to blip the engine until we got the propeller horizontal. Now, at Pocklington, I succeed in getting the propeller horizontal, but if I try as I might, I was unable to achieve that. At Sutton Bank, so you'll see me landing with a stationary vertical propeller, which I would have been told off for when I learnt to glide back in the day. Thank you. I don't recall concrete runways at Pocklington. When I went gliding there, I landed on the grass. Having said that, it's been a long time, and this is stock scenery. So either things have changed, or the scenery might just be a bit off. So we backtrack, and after a bit of a overly enthusiastic turn into wind, take off en route to Sutton Bank. Sutton Bank Gliding Club is located on Hill to the west of Pickering and is notable both for the sharp drop-off at the end of its main runway with the white horse painted on it, and also for the marginally hazardous public footpath that runs along the threshold of the same runway. It was from Sutton Bank that I had my one and only experience of an aeroto in a Blahnik glider. You can see the white horse just as we turn onto the left-hand downwind leg. So turn off the engine as we get close to the end of the downwind leg, and here you see the dreaded vertical propeller. Give the engine a blip and nothing happens. So we're stuck with the vertical propeller for the landing. If I'm honest, I come in a bit high and a bit quick on this landing, and you will notice that I balloon slightly, but don't bounce, which is always a bonus. the Scheibe Falk in Air Training Corps Colours by VSKYLABS. Not the quickest way of flying around the X-Plane universe, but certainly a lot of fun. Thank you for watching. If you found this video interesting or entertaining, I'd be grateful if you could like and subscribe. Thank you very much.